Hey guys, it's Lucy, and today we're going to learn how to hold the bow and a few exercises that can help develop some flexibility in your right hand. Let's get started. First, put your thumb on the edge of the frog and make sure that your thumb is curled. Then, wrap your middle and ring fingers on the other side of the frog. The fourth finger or ring finger should be around where the little circle is. And now, let your index finger naturally drop down. It should be at a comfortable distance from your middle finger. So not too extended and not too close to the middle finger. And finally, we're going to place the pinky on top of the stick. And that's your basic bow hold. In the beginning, you might find it difficult to keep your pinky curled, or your pinky might slip down the frog like this. So it's very important that we train our pinkies to become stronger and develop some muscles over here. And one of my favorite exercises for that is the pinky push-up. And you can start practicing this exercise by using a pen or pencil. I recently found this jumbo pen at home and it really comes in handy for this exercise. The way to do it is to hold your pen like you would a bow. And without moving your hand or other fingers, push the pen down with only your pinky and then return. Keep repeating this push-up motion and you're training your pinky muscles to become stronger. After practicing your pinky push-ups on your pen or pencil, you can now try it on your bow. Now this is going to be more difficult because your bow is heavier. So rather than trying to do it as quick as possible, just focus on getting the correct motion and do it in a slower pace. Another way to strengthen your pinky muscles is to do these pinky tapping motion on any flat surface. So you can really do this exercise anywhere. Place your second, third, and fourth fingers on a table and start tapping your pinky like a little hammer. And make sure to only allow yourself to use your pinky. So don't move your other fingers. And over time, you'll feel that your pinky is getting stronger and the tapping sound getting louder. So it's a really good way to keep track of your progress. After these exercises, but still without the violin, you can start practicing how to draw the bow on your shoulder. And I suggest this because the violin can be distracting when you're first learning how to draw the bow. First, I'm going to use a towel or cloth and put it on my shoulder so that the rosin doesn't get all over me. And then I'm just going to put my bow on my shoulder and start drawing. And this is the time where you want to check with yourself to see whether your fingers are staying flexible, your pinky and thumb curled. And you want to really feel your arm weight on your shoulder. I like to think of it as spreading peanut butter on a slice of bread. It should be very gluey and sticky. If you still want additional help on getting your pinky to stay curled or prevent it from slipping, you can try using a pinky house. It is basically a little circular house that sits on top of the frog, and your pinky will sit in it so that it doesn't move around so much. I actually made a separate video on how to make your own pinky house, and I will leave the link down below. It only takes a few minutes to make, and it's really a great tool for learning how to hold the bow. And that's basically it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you find this tutorial helpful. Please click the like and subscribe button so we can keep making more of these videos for you. Have a great day, and I will see you in the next video.